said, Lord, I thank you that I wasn't in the number, but I have another opportunity. For your word says, this is the day. This is the opportunity. I'll lift you up. I'll lift you up. I step forward and present my life. I step forward and say, Lord, who I am. Who I am to worship. I'll lift you up.
I lift
you up. You know, come on over and open up your mouth and bless it.
I lift you up.
See, somebody died in the freeze. But you are here. Open up your mouth. Give him praise. Dominion and power belongs to him. Say yeah.
You're worthy, Lord.
There is none like him in all the land.
You're worthy, Lord.
You can search all over. You can search all over, high and low, different places. But you will never find another righteous one like him. Yeah. Can we just stay down? Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Stay right there. Stay right there. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
One song said, tragedies are coming. I still bless your name. I'm still here. I still have another opportunity. Oh, hallelujah.
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 Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Well, praise the Lord. God bless you. Amen. Why are we here? Listen. Why are we here? It would be a shame to come this far and not completely enter into battle. I'm gonna pick on you a little bit. Just move her to the side a little bit so I can see. I need to see through here. Amen. Listen, I'm gonna pick on you a little bit. We got too much calm on my end. Somewhere gonna pick on you a little bit. Because you know, part of who I am, I'm coaching. Sometimes you gotta let the pastor be a coach. Y'all Anybody ever played sports? Come on, anybody ever played sports? Let me see the hand. Everybody, most of all, played sports. It'd be a shame for the coach just to have to go along with the team all the time. Because the team want to have fun, and because the team think this is all we're going to put into it. You get your coach for a reason, right? The coach can't outrun half of you. He can't outjump you. But he got an eye where he can see talent, ability. He can see slackers. He can see that sometimes the best people on the bench because they got attitude. Hello. And then he got to form out for, in the case of high school, back when I went to school, he'd say, well, now, that person's good enough to play varsity, but they call it red shirt today. But I'm going to hold them back just a little bit. But I need them to put everything they got into it because I see the potential. But I'm going to tell you one thing coach won't let you do. Everybody know that. You ain't just going to show up to practice. Am I right about it? Let's praise the Lord for the coach. I had a father in my life, but next to my father, the greatest inspiration, I had plenty of uncles, was a coach. Anybody, any brothers know what I'm talking about? You had that coach, that one coach. Thank you, sir. You had that one coach, man. You played football, didn't you? Had that one coach, man. You know, he wasn't impressed by this or that. He was on, you know, he was there to do one thing. He was there for a season, and I still take this coach with me today. I had a coach. So here's what I'm going to do, because, you know, I don't care nothing about TV land and all that stuff. We ain't performing here. I'm going to ask my younger teammates, if y'all will come up front. I want everybody behind the third row that's under the age of 21. Come up here. Yeah, come on up here. See, because some of us been in church long enough that we played on the back row, didn't we? Raise the hand on your back seat. Play with one day. Yeah, man. No, I don't want you up here. I want you to sit up here. Go sit up here, babies. Come on, get in. I want you in the game today. Come on, sit up front. Y'all can spread out. Sit up front, man. Yeah. Now, I'm going to teach you something. And the older players gonna help us too. Tie your shoe up, son. I'm gonna read something to you. The first thing we gonna learn, and the older players gonna teach the younger players. Because that's why the older players is in the game. You hear me, Joy? Praise God. Gonna teach you something. Because thank God for the music and the worshipers and all that. But the whole point of showing up is to get into the game. All right, Asian. All right? Praise God. Now, listen. The first thing we're going to learn today, and I don't care who's listening, who watching, we're going to learn how to lift our hands. That's the first thing we're going to do. Now, I'm going to give you the instructions here. It says, I will lift my hands. I will pray and praise the Lord. I'm going to read some scripture to you. Psalm 88:9, every day I call upon you. Oh Lord, I spread out my hands to you. The first way we get in the game of worship and game of life, beloved, is we learn. That's what makes us the difference. See that cross right there? A cross. I don't have one on today. What makes the cross different is that we spread our hands. We the only people that say, my trust is in the man that hung on the cross. So I identify by spreading my hand. When we come to worship, that's the first thing that lets the coach know, which really is the Holy Spirit, that you're ready to play now. You're ready to get in. Amen. I'm not the owner of the team. But the Holy Spirit, when he sees, okay, this one is ready now to be a part of something, to do something. And you know what he's looking for? In sports, he's looking for you to run faster when everybody else is at the water fountain. In sports, looking for you to jump higher when everybody else is trying to sit down. But in our call, what he looks looks for is some form of worship. Now, we're just going to look at, for a few seconds here, the raising of hands. We could get into clapping. We could get into dancing. We could get into singing. We're not going to go there. We're going to look at the first couple of things. So he says, I will spread out my hands. Would y'all help me? Would y'all just join in with me, beloved? Come on. Everybody in the room, spread out your hands. Now, I've had four shoulder surgeries. Four. Two on each shoulder. You put them down now. Two on each shoulder. And really, my shoulders are broken. I need to have two more. But I lift my hands, and I'm not trying to say it's about me. But I lift my hands anyway because while I got a chance, when I get tired, I just bring them down. But I'm not going to ever come to church. You will never. I promise you. Watch me. Keep your eyes on Jesus, but watch me. You will never see me come in this service and go out, and you never saw me lift my hand. I give you a $100 bill if you do. If it's a worship service. All you got to do is say, Pastor, I got it on tape. You never lifted your hands throughout the whole service. You know why? Because we are commanded to worship. And I say that to the rest of you, even some of you who are watching. I would never let it be seen that I went into the house of God and never broke my hands, at least this far, because I got broke shoulders and can get them this far, but when they start hurting, I just bring them on down to here. And if they need to hurt some more, I bring them out to here. I rest them. Bring them back up, because I'm here to lift my hands and worship. I'm not here to fake it till I make it. I'm not here to make you think. I am here to get something from the anointing. And I'm teaching you how you draw on the anointing. A lot of old folks don't know this. So, one more time, babies. Spread your hands for me. Thank you. That is our posture. See the cross? That's us. We ain't Muslims. We Christians. That's what makes us different. Praise God. All right, put them down. One more. Oh, Lord, I call upon you. Hasten to me. Give ear to my voice when I call to you. Give ear to my voice when I call to you. Let my prayer be counted as incense before you, and the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice. So, Lord, when I pray, hear me. But let my prayer be like incense. And when I lift up my hands, let it be like offering an evening, a sacrifice in the evening. See? And that's what it is to God. When he looks and see that, you know, I know you're hurting. I know your body hurt. I know you're young. This ain't your thing right now. I know you're old. You got something else on your mind. I know something happened in your life. Something ain't going right in your life. Stuff bad at the house. Your finances jacked. But, oh, my God, you are making a sacrifice. It's a sacrifice. The Holy Ghost says, I got to go and get with that man, that woman. It's a sacrifice. It's a sacrifice. The Bible says Solomon even stood before the altar of the Lord in the presence of all the assembly of Israel and spread out his hands. Solomon made a brass platform, 5 cubits long, 5 cubits high. That means it was big. And then he knelt on his knees in the presence of the assembly of Israel, and he spread out his hands toward heaven. You know what that tells me? That tells me that even as a leader, that you never get so big of a shot that you can't get down before God and spread your hand. And I'm not doing it for show. But no matter how big we think we are, so you're not too big. I'm not too big. None of us are too big to get on our knees if we wanted to. I'm not going to ask you to do that. But Solomon, the wisest king, wise beyond anybody we'll ever meet, he spread his hands to the Lord. He got on his knees before all of the people. Can we just spread our hands one more time, everybody? Amen. Now close your eyes and just say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you for my life. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for healing. Thank you for deliverance. Praise God. Thank you. Now take about 15 seconds and thank him in your way. Yeah. Thank him in your way. Yeah, just thank him in your way. Come on, young people. Come on, old people. on, sick people. Come on, people about to die. Come on, people with a lot of money. Come on, people that got it going on. Successful people. Holy people. Unholy people. Praise Him. Hallelujah. That's what the word of the Lord says. Listen, it says, and Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, and all the people answered and said, Amen. And when the people said Amen, they lifted up their hands and they bowed their heads and worshiped the Lord with their faces to the ground. Do you know our God, the God that we serve, He's worthy to be worshiped with our whole body. Not just words, but with our body and with our heads bowed at times, with our heads lifted up, with our hands spread, to praise Him with clapping. Everybody, clap, 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 clap. Now, you know why we tell you to clap? Not because we're control freaks. We tell you to clap because it too is a sacrifice. And what it tells Satan is that you stepped out. It says to your adversary, you have no business. Clapping means joy. You know, even chimpanzees clap. All human beings, have you ever noticed that humans, when they get excited about something, you could be watching the Gong Show or watching America's Got Talent, and when human beings get excited, they clap. That's a weird kind of a thing. If you look at it from that perspective, just watch a group of human beings. When they get excited, the one thing they're going to do in unison to show that, they're going to clap. This thing of putting their palms together. And these are not people that are in church. They clap. When you clap unto the Lord, what you are, anybody ever had an enemy? Nobody but me. You never had somebody that really just didn't like you, that was always trying to set a trap for you? Somebody that bullied you? Anybody ever been bullied? I've been bullied. What clapping does in a bully's face is say, I ain't scared. Have you ever seen that movie when the guy got a gun on somebody and this person is talking, just bring it, bring it, bring it. Do you know that diffuses your enemy? We are not here because we don't have an opposing team against us. Listen to me. We're not here, brothers and sisters, because there's not opposition in our life somewhere. If you came through the door and I just came to worship, you need to understand that opposite of worship is opposition. Come here, Mario. Just hold her hand down. Just keep it down. Opposite, try to worship. Opposite of worship is opposition. There is an enemy against God. Relax. There's an enemy against God who is himself wanting to worship. His name is Lucifer, Satan. He wants worship. That's why he lost his job in heaven. He wanted worship. So now that he is not in heaven to get any of the worship, he's in the earth, and his assignment against every old man and every young man is to keep them, come on, from worshiping. Because he knows, now lift them up, that if anybody, man or woman, would lift their hands unto God, victory will come to their life. Yeah. I want you to remember that. That in order to lift your hands, you have an opposing force. Not one time does the devil ever say, go for it. You know why? He knows that if you lift your hands, heaven comes and releases power on you. And religion has taught us, give me your other hand, baby, to take our hands and to hide them. This is a sign that I'm holding something back. Now, some of us, I do it sometimes because, I get tired and have to kind of bring myself to form. But really, anybody that does this, it's a sign that I got something I don't want to share. I'm holding something back. And so subconsciously, you may not know, religion taught us, keep your hands folded. All this may seem holy, but it's not. Because the Bible say, it doesn't tell us to fold our hands. What does it say? Say it in the mic, son. What does it say? Lift our hands. He never said fold your hands. Folding your hands is a sign of stress. This is what you do when you're weary. Are you working to connive? Are you trying to figure something out? Watch people when they're doing this here. This is a sign that somebody else can take it. This is a sign that I still got it. You may not believe that, but it's so true. So, I hope I appeal to the God in you. That the Bible says in the last day, I am going to pour out my spirit on all flesh. Can all flesh say amen?
Amen.
He says on my young girls and my older women, on my young men and my old men, gonna pour out of my spirit on all flesh. Wouldn't you like that to happen to you?
Yeah.
Wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? Now, how many of y'all are filled with the Holy Spirit? Yeah. How many of you want to be filled with God's power? Raise your hand. If you don't want to, it ain't no problem. You want to, right? To be filled with God's Spirit, the first thing you must do is you must be open to receive the Spirit. And you start by lifting your hands. You do. How many got the Spirit? Clap your hands if you do. Sure. How many want more of the Spirit? Amen. Let me tell you how. You start by lifting your hands to worship. What has happened is that we have taken for granted how to fill up a cup. I drink tea a lot, and every single time I have a cup of tea, I pour it into an open cup. Why? Or coffee. I have never in my life, my adult life, my kid life, had the cup turned upside down and I tried to pour. When you get a glass of milk, do you turn the glass upside down and pour the milk? When you get some Kool-Aid or juice from the refrigerator, come on, look at me now. Look at me now. You thirsty. You've been out playing. Do you come in, reach up and get a cup, turn it upside down and pour? And then try to drink from the top of that cup, what's left? No, you don't, do you? You make sure it's clean. You fill that cup up. When you learn what I'm telling you, to just worship, clap your hands, worship, it's like a cup being turned right side up so the Spirit can pour into you. And even though you are young, He still wants to pour into you. This girl received the baptism of the Holy Spirit at 4 years of age. Don't mean you're gonna not have challenges in life, but at 4 years of age, you can be filled with the Holy Spirit. You all are called to do this and replace it. These folk getting old. Can I get an amen from the gallery? They beautiful now. They look all good and they black, African, but they ain't getting old. Can I get an amen out here? They ain't gonna say it, but they getting old. They getting old. See that piano player? He getting old. Somebody got to learn how to play that piano. Somebody got, see that, see the lady over in the blue dress? Somebody got to grow up and wear a blue dress. See the ladies in the dashiki, somebody got to take that place. See the lady singing bass right here? Somebody got to sing bass. Somebody got to take, see the Mario, I mean the Rams and Brothers? Somebody got to take their place, man. They getting old. Look at them. They got kids. So, the Holy Ghost, Asia, is forming you, getting you ready. So come on, get in the game. Come on. We're trying to move you to the varsity. Come on, stand on your feet. Come on. Come on, stand on your feet. Lift your hands for me. For Jesus. Don't be afraid. Yeah, somebody got to become a person. Somebody got to become a pastor. Somebody got to become an elder. Come on. Come on. Somebody got to take their place. Yeah, yeah. Josiah was 8 years old when he began to rule. Josiah was 8 years old when he became king of a whole nation. Come on, get with me. Help me. Come on. Let's praise the Lord. Say it with me. I praise the Lord. Oh, mama didn't buy you all them pretty teeth for nothing. Come on, say praise the Lord. Say praise the Lord. Come on, say praise the Lord. Help me, Jordan. Say praise the Lord. Come on, I know it's in you. Say praise the Lord. Come on, say praise the Lord. Praise.